This is part one of adding and subtracting rational expressions that have different denominators. All right, let's do a little review for when we are adding fractions that have the same denominator. So here's an example where we have a subtraction problem and we have the same denominator. And so remember what we do is we subtract the numerators. Now with this minus sign, remember you're going to subtract this whole numerator up here. So we've got 2x plus 3, and I'm going to subtract x minus 2. So that'll be a minus x and a plus 2 once you distribute your minus sign. And you write the denominator down once. Okay? And the next thing to do is to simplify the numerator. So if we just combine like terms, that gives us x plus 5 over x squared minus x minus 30. Now the last thing to do anytime you're dealing with fractions is see if you could reduce the fraction at all. So in this case we could see if we could factor the denominator to see if that x plus 5 would cancel. Remember you can't cancel the x's because you can only cancel factors. So if you want, think of the numerator still as something in parentheses. All right, now the denominator factors to, let's see, x minus 6 and x plus 5. Now, you could do that on scratch paper, but that's what it factors out to. So notice that x plus 5 will cancel with the numerator. If you want, you could sort of cross this out and say, well, it's really just the same thing as x minus 6 over x plus 5. So if I put parentheses around that numerator, it might help you. You can cancel the x plus 5s, but remember that means there's a 1 left in the numerator. So our final answer would be 1 over x minus 6. So we did a lot of these in previous videos, that's a little review, but now we're going to do some problems where we don't have a common denominator to begin with. Here's an example where I do not have a common denominator. The first fraction has 6x, the second fraction has 9x squared. All right, we could use a little jealousy method here where we write each denominator in factored form, just the denominator. So 6 is 2 times 3 times x, and second one is 3 times 3 times x times x. And the idea is each fraction wants to have the same factors. So this first denominator looks over, and if the other denominator has something it doesn't have, it takes it on. So for instance, it looks over, this other denominator has two factors of 3, it only has one, so it needs a factor of 3. And whatever you multiply the numerator by, you multiply the denominator by. And then it looks over, it has two factors of x, it also needs an x. So now, this first denominator has all the factors necessary, and that is the least common denominator. So the least common denominator has 5 factors, and you have to make sure the other denominator has the exact same 5. So it already has 4, right? It's only missing the 2. So the second denominator needs a 2 over a 2. So now we've got a common denominator, which we could leave in factored form, or, in this case, it's easier to multiply it out, and that's going to give you 2 times 3 times 3. That's going to be 18x squared. And in the numerator for the first one, we've got 5 times 3 times x. That's 15x. And in the second one, we've got 14. Now, don't try to cancel, because remember, what we're doing is writing equivalent fractions, so we want to keep that denominator. So what we've done is we've written 5 over 6x plus 7 over 9x squared with a common denominator. All right, so once we have a common denominator, we can put it all over that denominator and you add the numerators. So we have 15x plus 14, and that's the answer to this problem. By the way, you would always see if you could factor and cancel, but in this case, the numerator, you can't factor at all. All right, now some people might do this a little bit differently than writing the prime factorization and using the jealousy method. So if you wanted to do it a different way, you would look and see, well, what's the least common denominator? And some of you might just realize, well, between 6 and 9, it's 18. And for the x and the x squared, I'll need at least an x squared, and that works as well. So for instance, if you can see that that's going to be the least common denominator in your head, you could say, well, how am I going to get this least common denominator of 18x squared? In other words, if you know that the least common denominator is 18x squared, you could say, what do I have to multiply 6x by to get that? That would be 3x, and the same thing in the numerator. And in the denominator, I would need a 2. And notice, when you multiplied the first numerators together, you would have 15x. And then plus the second numerators together, you'd have 7 times 2 is 14. You would get exactly the same answer, 15x plus 14. All right, so here's another problem. The denominators of the difference are different. I have a 6x and a 4x. Notice they both have a factor of x, and then the coefficient part of each is 6 and 4. So basically, we need the least common denominator of 6 and 4. If you could do that in your head, it's a little bit faster. That would give you 12x. So the trick is, how could you make both denominators 12x? One thing I suggest you do is leave a little space to do your multiplication. So if you have 3x minus 4 over 6x, leave some space, okay, for what you're going to have to multiply by. And then the other factor is, I'm sorry, the other fraction, you want to leave space to multiply its numerator and denominator as well. Also, be careful that this is a whole quantity that you're going to multiply something by. All right, so if I'm going to get 12x, I'm going to have to multiply this denominator, this first denominator, by 2 over 2. That'll give me my 12x, and my second one I'll have to do by 3 over 3. And here's where you have to be pretty careful with your subtraction sign here. In the first fraction, we're going to go ahead and do the distributive property. And it looks funny to have the 2 on the outside, but you're still just distributing that 2 to what's inside the parentheses. So we're going to have 6x minus 8 over 12x minus, then I've got 3 I have to distribute as well. So I've got 6x minus 15. Now be careful, this minus sign out in front of the fraction is still there, so you're going to have to distribute that minus sign now at the next step. Alright, so now we have finally a common denominator of 12x, and we're going to subtract the numerators, so we have 6x minus 8, and we have to distribute the minus sign, so it's a minus 6x and a plus 15. So what happens here? In the numerator, 6x minus 6x is gone, and you have negative 8 plus 15, so that's 7 over 12x. You know that can't be reduced, 7's prime, right? So that's our final answer for this one. Here's one for you to try. Notice I've left some space here so that I can multiply each fraction by something. So a little hint is, if you want, you can just put times, leave a little space. So go ahead and try this on your own. All right, so we have to get the least common denominator between 9m and 12m squared. You could do this by factoring, or if you could figure out between 9 and 12 the least common denominator, that works as well. If you did it by factoring, just keep in mind that's a 3 times a 3 times an m, and this is a 2 times a 2 times a 3 times an m times an m. Okay? So what's missing from this first one are two factors of 2, right? 2 times 2 is really 4, right? And an m. So I'm going to end up multiplying by 4m. Now, notice that ends up giving 36m squared for the least common denominator, which probably most of you could have figured that out for between 9 and 12. All right, so I'm also going to need a 3m over here, right, to get the same denominator. I'm sorry, just a 3 to get the 36m squared. So in the numerator, I've got 8m over 36m squared minus 15 over 36m squared. And then we just subtract the numerators. And then we see if we can cancel. We can't because we can't factor anything to cancel. So that's our answer. All right, so this is just a little introduction, and then we're going to go on to the next video and do ones where we have more complicated denominators.